few brownies at the Code Pink table that I made, and they're really, really special. They don't have any kind of medicine in them or anything like that. They're just chocolate, which is really good for you. So come by our table, and Eleanor will be sitting there, our wonderful Eleanor Levine will be sitting there dispensing the brownies for a donation. I'm actually up next, and does anybody not know what this represents? Because what I wanted to do was to show you what we did with the hood, because there's no senses loud, there's no sound, there's no sight, there's no hearing, there's nothing. When you are captured and renditioned and sent to Guantanamo, you have no senses available to you. And we've heard horrible, horrible stories of torture. And that torture continues. They let somebody out yesterday, right? They let a Kuwaiti out, but there are still about 50 Guantanamo prisoners who were cleared for release many, many years ago who are still in Guantanamo prison. And we need to let them out. Cheney to take off the gloves. He said, your ass is covered by these legal memos, these legal opinions I'm giving you, and you can do this and not have to worry about ever being prosecuted. Well, he was wrong. John Yu was wrong on every count. They rescinded his legal opinions because they were shoddy research, they were not good law, and he is teaching students law? Is that okay?
No!
Tomorrow is the anniversary of Guantanamo receiving its first prisoners, and some of us are going to go to the law school tomorrow because that's sort of symbolic, because they employ that war criminal. We're going to go up there and we're going to call for his indictment and prosecution once again, and we have been doing this for years. And just, the law school doesn't respond. They don't respond. They've endowed a chair for John Yu. To add insult to injury, they've endowed a chair for John Yu. And you know who pushed for that? The former dean of the law school, Christopher Edley, who said that he agreed that John Yu did the wrong thing. Yeah, yeah, so they're full of it, but we're not going up there tomorrow to call for his firing. We're going up there to call for his prosecution, because that is what he should happen to him. No man is above the law, they say, and this is true. And we have to make sure it's true in our country, because if people are above the law, then what have we got? The Wild West or something. Okay, the other thing.
What time is
your demonstration? We're meeting at noon in front of the law school. It's on Bancroft Way and College Avenue. And we are a delegation. We are not hundreds of people. The media likes to say, 5 people showed up, or 20 people showed up. It's not about how many are showing up. It's about what we're calling for and what we are saying over and over again. John, you should be in prison. You should be in the dock. Okay? So it's not okay. We need to shut Guantanamo prison. We can't continue. So I'm urging everybody to do what they know they have to do, which is to pressure Obama, because it is solely his decision. It's blaming it on Congress, as we know, is just a cop-out. He has the authority to tell Congress, in 30 days I want to release these 45 people. All he has to do is notify them. In 30 days they can be out. So that's all it takes. Now, many of you know that I was on a hunger strike for 84 days. And I wasn't alone in that. There were prisoners at Guantanamo still on hunger strike, and they were the inspiration for that. And there were prisoners at Pelican Bay and prisons around the country who were held in solitary who were also on hunger strikes, and they were the inspiration for that. And Witness for Peace's just went to Guantanamo and tried to get as close to the prison as they could. And they are fasting, they're on hunger strike right now in Washington, D.C., in the freezing cold there. They are not eating. Okay, what can we do? We can go and call for the prosecution of John Yoo, who is responsible for the torture that those men have endured at Guantanamo prison. And I mentioned Jamel Amitsian earlier, the Algerian who was repatriated to Algeria. He is suing the United States with the help of the Center for Constitutional Rights. Because he was tortured. It wasn't just three people who were waterboarded. That is a crock, okay? Lots of them were waterboarded and lots of them were tortured. And we can't let that stand. We have to do something about that. So please join us tomorrow at 11 at UC Law School. And then witness, Code Pink and World Can't Wait are meeting at 1 o'clock at Montgomery Street Station in San Francisco. And we have some of these orange jumpsuits for you to wear. And we are going to march in solemn procession through downtown San Francisco just to remind people that prison's still there. And those people are still suffering, and we can't let that happen any longer.